Hi, in this video, we're going to explain the functions of the Instructor Operating Station of the GLIME Virtual Cockpit, BATD. The Instructor Operating Station gives you access to control a number of features in the simulator environment, including your aircraft favorites, the location, the weather conditions, and allows you to monitor the flight in real time, as well as record the flight to play it back later to review with your students. Let's discuss how each function works. To select an aircraft, you just simply click on the aircraft that you would like to fly. Currently have the choice of the Cessna 172 with the analog gauges and the Cessna 172 with the G1000. To set the location, you can either select from a pre-programmed location favorite or you can set a custom location. To set the location, you can either start on the ground, on an approach, or in the air. If you'd like to start on the ground, first select your airport. In this case, we have KGNV. Press enter, and then you can select a runway position to start at the departure end of the runway. If you know the precise latitude and longitude, you can enter it here. You can also select a heading for the aircraft, or if you selected the runway, the aircraft heading will already be positioned to fly the heading of the takeoff runway. If you select an approach, you can select the runway for the approach, as well as a distance from the approach end of the runway. 3, 5, or 10 nautical miles are pre-selected options, or you can enter a custom distance, such as 6 miles. When you select the approach to set the position, it will automatically position the aircraft on a 3-degree glide slope. If you select the position in the air, you can point anywhere on the map. You can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. You can select the position by clicking anywhere on the map. You can set the aircraft heading, altitude, or airspeed. You can also set the position relative to a VOR using a bearing to or from the station, and the distance. That will allow you to set a precise position relative to that station. Once you have a position selected, press the Set Location button, and it will configure the aircraft and the location for the parameters that you have selected. If you want to save that location for use later, press the Add to Favorites Location button, and enter a position number, and it will allow that to show up on the flight setup menu under your location favorites. To set the weather conditions, you can select from 8 pre-selected conditions from ceiling and visibility OK, VFR, marginal VFR, a non-precision approach, IFR categories 1, 2, or 3, or stormy weather conditions. You can also customize the weather using the custom weather button. Here, you can enter the air temperature, dew point, pressure, the time of day, the visibility, the wind gusts, the wind direction, a turbulence factor, an amount of wind shear. You can set the precipitation type and intensity, the cloud tops and the cloud bases, the type of clouds, and the density of the clouds. You can also save the weather conditions to your favorites. When setting one of these parameters, you can use either the plus or minus buttons, or you can click on the parameter and enter a custom variable. If you'd like to toggle the day or nighttime, use the day or nighttime toggle switch, or use the plus or minus buttons to enter the time of day. When entering wind, the wind speed in knots can be set in increments of 5 from 0 to 30. You can also set a gust factor, which will show the amount of increase on top of the wind speed. For example, if the wind speed is 5 and the gusts are 10, your wind will be 5 gusting to 15. The direction is the direction that the wind is coming from times 10. So 18 would be a wind from the south, or 180 degrees. Turbulence intensity is from 0 for no turbulence to 10, which would be extreme. You can also set a wind shear factor in increments of 5. When you have precipitation, if you would also like to have thunderstorms, click the thunderstorms button and it'll highlight it in green. The cloud tops and bases are set in hundreds of feet above the ground. The plus minus buttons on the left side will set the tens digits and hundreds digits, and the plus minus buttons on the right side will set the single digits. To activate and deactivate systems failures, click on the failures button. When you start the simulator control, this will allow you to control the aspects of the simulator. Clicking on an option will highlight in red. For example, if we fail the electrical system, this shows in red. And as you can see, the electrical system has failed on the screen. Clicking the button again will turn it green and will activate that system again. Note that if you fail the engine, when you turn the engine back on or turn the failure off, the engine will not start back up. The pilot will have to start the engine using the engine restarting procedures. To monitor the flight that's in progress, click on the moving map option. Here we can see the aircraft is moving down the runway during takeoff. We can see the airspeed is increasing, and as he departs, the altitude will increase, and when a heading changes, a vertical speed changes, you'll be able to monitor it here. You can also see the aircraft is climbing in altitude. The green on the bottom of the elevation tape is the height of the ground below the aircraft. You can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out on the map, or you can use the plus minus controls to zoom in and out. You can also click to drag the map around to a position. You also have the capability to pause the flight in case you wanted to freeze it so that you can discuss any activity with your student. Pressing the start button will resume the flight. If you want to view the engine data instead of the aircraft telemetry, click the engine data button. This will show you the RPM, oil pressure, oil temperature, manifold pressure, exhaust gas temperature, cylinder head temperature, and the fuel flow. If you want to record the flight, press the start button next to record flight. The flight is now recording. To stop recording the flight, press the stop button, and then you can enter your custom text to save that flight. To access the recorded flights, click the recorded flights button. Here we see the flight that we just saved. Pressing load will load the flight, and then you may press the playback button and the play button to play the flight. From here, you can review the maneuvers with your student. If you have any questions about using the instructor operating station, feel free to reach out to our team at 1-800-874-5346, or you can contact us online.